Good day, fellow noobs. Today I'm going to show you how to group dates in a pivot table. Two ways to group them. One is to group them directly. Another is by using helper columns. Okay, so let's go to the first one. So I have here a set of dates and status. Normally what you'd find in a standard set of data with a date column. The direct way is you go to the insert tab, click on pivot table. I'm gonna have this go to the existing worksheet and click on OK. Scroll this. So this is just the direct way. So you put in the dates on the rows, the columns on the stats, and so you have the dates grouped. Now if you want to have some variability on the groups, let's say if you want to group it by year, so I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to click on group, and we have a couple options here. We can group it by seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, quarters, and years. So if you want to group it by years, you click on years, and so I only have year 2021, so that's what's showing. So if you want to get that back, I'm going to click on ungroup and then group again. I want to group it by years and months. I'm going to have the year here and the month dimensions here. Okay, I'm going to ungroup it again. If I want to group it by days, I'm going to click on days and one on month. This box will be open here. It's basically saying how many days do you want it to be grouped. So for example, if I put in here 3, it is going to group the dates from the earliest date that you have in your data. So for example, in this data, I had the date that it started with was January 5. So it groups the dates every 3 days because that's what we put in on the days box earlier. So this is January 5, January 6, and January 7. Then it groups the other days into 3 days. If we want to group it by 7 days, I'm going to click on days again. Have this by 7, and so this is now grouped by 7 days. Okay, so this is the first way. I'm gonna ungroup this again. I'm gonna remove this. And so the second way is by using helper columns. Now a helper column is basically you're just building additional formulas with your existing data. So for example, we're typing here. So I want to have a separate column for the year. We type in the year formula. I want to get the month. I'm going to type in month. You can type in month, open parenthesis, month, open parenthesis, and the value. Then you're going to copy it down. If you want to get the actual month name, you can type it in a text formula. So text, and then you need to get the value. And you have to enter the format, which is going to be an open parenthesis, 4 M's, then close. So we have the whole word. And then from here, we can build again the pivot table. So I'm going to have it go in on the existing worksheet again. So we have more options to choose here. I'm still going to put the status on the columns. I'm going to put in the year. And then I can put in the month name. It's still grouped similarly, or I can put in the month, and that's it. So one downside to this is if you want to put in weeks, for example, I'm gonna put in a week. If it's just numbers, it's still gonna work, but if you put in, for example, your own format for the week, which is going to be like this, for example, if you want it to go out as week. So the week formula, it just starts to count from January 1. So it counts January 1 as the first week, and then the last week of the year is going to be week 52. Now, one downside of this is it removes the default ordering in Excel. So put in here status again, Now, if we put in week, you'll notice that it's no longer in the right order because it assumes that it's in a text format. But yeah, so one option is we can remove the text part, and we can just put in the normal one. So this is put in sort A to Z. Now we have the normal weeks. So we can put in the years, the month period, or maybe you can put in the month name. So there, so this is for January, this is week 2 of the year, week 2 to 5, and that's for the succeeding months. And that's it. Again, I hope you find this useful. If you have any questions, feel free to enter on the comment below. Thank you and good night.